Welcome back. We're now going to start, I guess.
Start the white layer.
Start the white layer. Fam's going to finish the cake. Well, not finish it, but she's going to finish the basic part of the cake. So we're almost done, just adding the white layer on top. Had to mix the buttercream a little bit more because it wasn't very soft. Again, make sure your buttercream's soft because it's just going to be a way easier process for you to put on the icing if you make it really soft. And again, it doesn't have to be perfect. Like, Pam's getting a little bit of pink there. That's totally fine. It's ombre.
Okay. I'll finish up the top.
So like I was saying before, if you don't have one of these fancy spatulas that you can
buy one though.
You can buy one. It's a good investment if you want to make your own cakes at home. But if you don't have one, a knife is perfectly fine, like a butter knife, not a steak knife. That's ridiculous.
Or a paring knife.
Or a paring knife. Or a bread knife. Actually, maybe the end of a bread knife would work.
But this is great too for getting the cakes out of the pans.
Yes, it can. And you can use it for so many things.
Cleaning the edge off of anything.
Yeah.
It is.
So that's it.
So yeah, personally, I like it when there's a little bit of a style to it instead of just going smooth. So an easy way to do that is to add some textured lines to it. And again, on this rotating cake pedestal, it'll be super easy to just continually go around in circles. So if you have perhaps a lazy Susan.
Yes.
Or even just a couple plates on top of each other. Something that can move a little bit.
Everyone has a lazy Susan, right?
I don't know. I don't.
Oh, I don't, actually. I'm sure. Maybe I do. It's probably somewhere.
So the key for this is hot water. So we're just dipping that in there. And we're just going to run it along the cake. And then we'll just keep going around in lines.
And this doesn't have to be perfect. This is something you can just...
We're going to make it look rustic.
Creative free reign for this part. Hot water is definitely key, though. It just helps out the process. Don't get it too wet, like Pam's shaking it off a little bit.
And you don't want to pull off too much of the icing either, because next thing you know, you're going to be starting to get down into the layers of your base icing, and that's just going to look yucky.
So you could use this cake for a wedding, or because it's pink, baby shower. You could do any color, so you could do blue for a baby shower for a boy.
We've done a lot of blue ones.
Yeah.
It's a nice pattern that isn't too feminine.
Or a smash cake for a baby photo shoot. Maybe not two layers, maybe you just do one layer for that, but you can still do this cake in one layer. It doesn't need to be two for the ombre. You just obviously have to make the adjustment for one cake. What you can also do too is instead of just doing two layers of cake, you can do three layers, and that makes the cake taller. So that's what we do here, is we make a three layer cake for smash cakes, and that way it's a little bit taller, and then you don't have to do a two tier cake.
Looks great too for pictures.
Yes. And it's easy for the baby to get into and get all dirty.
Yeah.
And you could put, what else could you do with this cake? Put a banner on it.
Yeah, I think we're going to put a flower on it just to give it a final touch of something. Just jazz it up a little bit.
Pam is almost done.
Almost done.
Cleaning the edges a little bit, make it look real pretty.
So just take the top and pull it towards myself to the center. And we'll just smooth it out. Careful not to add too much water because those water droplets will sit on the cake. But you just use a little paper towel though and dab them up afterwards. I'll just clean up the bottom.
And also to clean up the bottom of your little cake here, you can use a cloth, wipe it all off to make it look pretty.
Mm-hmm. Trim it up nice.
And that's it.